Today, I want to look at something a little bit different. I've had a lot of requests from users of Affinity Photo about how to create luminosity masks. Now, if we were using Photoshop, there's a lot of shortcut keys you can use to create luminosity masks, but they don't translate into Affinity. So what do you do? Well, previously I demonstrated a technique where we can use the selection and make a selection based on tonal range, and then you can select the mid-tone shadows or highlights to work on. The problem is that doesn't give you a whole lot of control that you might get when you're using much more complicated luminosity masking techniques. So what I'm going to do today is show you how you can create sets of luminosity masks that target either progressively lighter or progressively darker tones, and how you can do it without using lots of keystrokes. Now, it makes it a little bit more complicated in one way, but also it makes it a little bit easier in another. So let's have a look at this picture of a volcano I shot over in Bolivia. The first thing I'm going to do is duplicate my layer. And now I'm going to desaturate that to give me a black and white image. And I'll click this merge button. And what that does is, rather than create saturation adjustment layer, it merges it down into the new layer that I created. So we now have the original image and a black and white image. And what I want to do now is I'm going to select one of these channels in the channels window. Actually, I'll move that out so we can see it a little bit better. And because it's a black and white image, all the channels are identical. So I can click on one of those and I can load that now to the pixel selection. So you can see the marching ant showing me what's been loaded. And you've got this useful option down here called a pixel selection. And if I right click on that, I can now create a spare channel. Just make this a bit taller, and you can see the new spare channel that we've created from the selection. And I'm going to rename that, and that is going to be Lights 1. The next thing I'm going to do is duplicate my background layer. And I'm going to change the blending mode to be multiply. And now I'm going to load one of the composite channels again to my pixel selection. And now I can save that as a spare channel. And I'll rename the spare channel Lights 2. Now I'm going to do the same again. Duplicate this channel. This time I don't need to set the blending mode to multiply because that's already been set in the previous layer that we've copied. I can now load one of the composite channels to a pixel selection and then save that as a new channel. And I'll rename that to be Lights 3. Now, I'm not going to continue to create any more lights channels. I'm sure you've got the idea by now of how to do that. Instead, we're going to now create our darks channels. Before I start though, I'm going to remove the first two layers that I created. Oh, sorry, the last two layers. We'll delete those, and I'm left with the first image, which was a desaturated image. I'm going to clear my selection, and I now want to invert this image, and I'm going to do that using the invert option. Now I can move back to my layers window, and here we can see the new layer that was created by the invert option. So I'm just going to merge that down now, and that will convert the background duplicate layer that was black and white into the inverse of itself. Now I'm going to load this as a pixel selection. Now I'll just move that out of the way so we can see what we're doing a little bit easier. And I want to take one of the composite channels now, and I want to load that to the pixel selection. So you can see the marching ants, you can see it's been loaded here, and now I'm going to create a spare channel from it, and I'll rename that spare channel to be Darks 1. Now, I'm going to duplicate this layer. And again, I'm going to set the blend mode to multiply. And now I can load that to a pixel selection, and I can save that as a spare channel. And we'll rename that Darks 2. And we'll just create one more layer here, duplicate that, load the composite channel, and then save the composite channel as a new spare channel, renaming it to Darks 3. So that's my selection of lights and darks channels created. Now I'm just going to delete all these channels here, sorry, layers here. So we'll delete those, and I'll just clear my selection. The next step is to create the mid-tone masks. And to do that, it's actually quite simple. All we have to do is make a complete selection of the image. So if we press Command and A, you've got the marching ants right around the image. It's made a complete selection. And then all we have to do is take the lights one and actually subtract them from the current pixel selection. And then we take the darks one and also subtract that from the pixel selection. And what we're left with is our midtones one selection. So I can now save that to a spare channel and rename it midtone one. Now I can do exactly the same. Command A to select the entire image. I can go to lights 2, subtract from the pixel selection, darks 2, subtract from the pixel selection, and now I can save the selection as a spare channel, and I can rename that to be midtones 2. And finally, let's do the same again. Command A selects everything. This time we'll use lights 3, subtract from pixels. Same now with darks 3, subtract from the pixel selection, and save the resulting selection as a spare channel. Let's rename that. I'm sure you've guessed, midtones 3. So there we are. We'll just clear the selection. We now have a set of luminosity masks that target the lightest areas of the image, the darkest areas of the image, or the midtones, going from a very narrow midtone range to a much wider midtone range. I'll quickly demonstrate how you might use this to, say, apply a midtone contrast adjustment to the image. I'll come over and I'll go to my curves, and I'll add a new curve with quite a steep contrast adjustment there, so you can see the way that's boosting all the colours in this image. And now I've got the new layer there, the curves layer, so I can just turn that on and off. And I'm just going to load my midtones as a pixel selection, so that's midtones 2 loaded. And now all I do is add a new mask. And the mask actually is the same as the midtones 2. So if I just turn off the selection, so we'll deselect that, and you can see that the mask has actually toned down the contrast adjustment, and it's now targeting just a narrow mid-tone. So if I turn the mask off, you can see the effect where the adjustment attacks some of the strongest or darkest areas as well, and it creates quite a heavy saturated colour. Whereas with the mask, it's applied the adjustment to the mid-tones, which is where we want it. So that's how you can create your lights, darks and midtone masks in Affinity Photo, and it gives you the same control as you would have had in Photoshop. I hope you found that useful. I'm Robin Whalley. I'll see you next time for another video.